art and architecture. I hope you guys are doing really well. You all are fine, you all are safe, and you all are at home. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking to you about a wall hanging that I have made recently. All of the material I have taken for making this wall hanging is available at home. You guys don't need to go outside. It's quite there at home. So I just want to show you how the wall hanging looks. So this is how the wall hanging looks like. So the strands you'll see beneath is a dupatta. It's a bandhani nylon dupatta that I used, and it was very colorful, so it added a nice look to the entire wall hanging. Obviously you can go for a plain dupatta as well, but just make sure when you have a plain dupatta going beneath, you have a colorful paper on the top so that it contrasts well. And you can keep the watchmaker sticks new, that won't be an issue. But just make sure these two colors contrast each other. This is paper. Obviously, this is a paper bow flower, you could say. And I have finished it with a button. And these are the watchmaker sticks I have used. Now, in case you don't have watchmaker sticks, you can always go with a hardboard or a mount board or any hard paper that you'll have. Cut it into strips and then start sticking it the way you like it. Now, this is a six-sided hexagon. That I've done. You can go for a square, a pentagon, any shape you like it. It could be a circle also. You can just cut rings with the cardboard and you can make the frame with a circular pattern as well. This is how the wall hanging look. I hope you guys really enjoy watching how I have done this. So if you want to know how I made this wall hanging, then please continue.
Okay, to make this wall hanging, all you need is a colored dupatta, a few watchmaker sticks, a glue to stick everything in place, a pair of scissors, and a white paper. Okay, so first we are going to start making the frame. Now to make the frame, take any shape you like. You can choose a square or rectangle. I have personally chosen an hexagon. Start placing the watchmaker sticks in the hexagon shape. Don't stick it initially. Stick it once you are satisfied with how your frame looks like. Now once you are ready with first layer of your frame, start placing two more layers of watchmaker sticks. This is how the frame looks like once you have attached four layers of stick. We are done with the frame. We will move further towards the bow. Now to make a bow, take a white paper and start cutting it into strips. Now the thickness of the strip I have taken is around 1 inch to 1.5 inch. You can also make it thinner or more thick. It's completely up to you. Once you're done cutting the strips, start sticking both the ends of the paper to each other with the help of a glue. This is how the paper looks like once you start sticking it. It needs to look like a petal. Further, you need a dupatta to make the strands. Now I have cut the dupatta into small pieces, and the thickness of each strand is around 2 to 3 centimeters. You can take as much you want. It can be thick, thin. It's completely on to you. Now further, I have taken the frame and I have started tying the strands to the frame. This is how you need to tie the This is how you need to tie the strands to your frame so that the knots are not visible. Once you are done tying the strands to the frame, attach a flower, and this is the complete result of how your wall hanging looks like.
And yeah guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys really enjoyed watching the wall hanging that I've made. Obviously you can experiment with the color of the dupatta, the color of the paper and also with the frame, but this is just a basic idea of how a wall hanging looks like. This looks like a very bohemian sort of a very, it has a very colorful and a very tangy vibe. So it's good to add in your informal room or in your working space to add a nice color to your room. You can obviously try it. And I hope you understood how I have made this. Do let me know in the comments down below if you like it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like my videos and share it with anyone who's interested in crafts and arts. I will see you guys in my next video with the next DIY and an interesting topic. Till then, stay safe. Take care of your health, be creative.